Hello students, in this video we will try to understand the making of the nationalism in Europe. As I told you in the earlier videos that the nation state is the state or the country where the territories are defined, the majority of the people constitute the country and the government is with the consent of the people, not the monarchy is there that who will rule over the population or the people. If we talk about the 18th century French, then what we see that it is divided into different parts. There were the many languages were also spoken by the people of the French. Territories were not defined, and the France was divided. French was divided into different parts. Now we will have a look in which parts it was divided. Germany, Italy, and Switzerland divided into kingdoms. Okay. These were the European countries. Okay, Germany, Italy, and Switzerland were divided into kingdoms. Duchies, and the kingdoms were the duchies, cantons, rulers, Ottomans, Ottoman territories. The rulers were the autonomous. Okay, they don't want to face any type of challenge or the opposition. The next is the Eastern and the Central Europe. The Eastern one and the Central Europe. There was the autocratic monarchies. Monarchies means the rule of the king or the emperor. The next one is in the Eastern and the Central Europe, diverse peoples spoke different languages, belonged to different ethnic groups. This is also the problem. The next one is the Habsburg Empire. Habsburg Empire is, we can say, is a patchwork. In this, many regions were included in this. They were the Austria, in Austria and Hungary. The Austria and Hungary ruled by the Habsburg Empire. In Hungary, the people were using the Magyar language or the dialectics. Okay. The next one is the Habsburg Empire includes the Alpine region, the Tyrol, the Austria and the Switzerland. Sorry, Sudetenland. The next one is the Bohemia is also included into the Habsburg Empire. Sorry, aristocracy predominantly speaking German. Here the aristocracy speaking German. Sorry, Lombardy and the Venetia, and in this territory Italian speaking provinces were also included, and the peasants were also living there. But in these type of differences, there was no possibility of the political unity. And the only one common thing in these territories or the region, that is the allegiance to emperor. And how this divided continent give rise to the nationalism, I will talk to the next topic. Thank you.